Hi Year 12s, in this video we're going to look at completing the square. Now some of you might have done this in class with me already, and that's fine, but I'm going to go through the process. So completing the square involves working on a quadratic equation like this, and it's a fairly mechanical process. And what we do is we start by looking at this part here, and we factorize that, we'll sort of factorize it. It's slightly different process to factorizing. But we halve that number in front of x, so we make it 4, and we've got that bracket squared. Now, this negative 17, we haven't touched that, so that's still here. We've still got negative 17, but there's actually something missing here, and I'll explain why we've got something missing. So if I looked at x minus 4 squared, that would be the same as x minus 4 times x minus 4, and that would expand to x squared minus 8x plus 16. Now that negative 8x, that there is, that just shows that when we expand this, we end up with that negative 8x there as well. But you'll notice that we've got this extra plus 16. And what we have to do is counteract that. So when we expand this, because we get that extra plus 16, we have to write minus 16 here to counteract that coming in. So what we end up with is all of that equal to 0, and as we simplify it, we get x minus 4 squared, and then minus 16 minus 17 is minus 33, and that equals to 0. Now from here, we solve it a little bit like a linear equation. So we add 33 to both sides, so I've got x minus 4 squared equals 33, and then we take the square root of both sides, so we have x minus 4 equals plus or minus 33, and then we add 4 to both sides, so we have x equals, and that should be square root of 33, equals 4 plus or minus the square root of 33. So just to go through that process again, we look at the number in front of x and we halve it, and that's the number that goes into our bracket, and then we have to work out what that bracket expands to so that we can counteract it, and that's what that negative 16 is. And then we simplify, and that's where that negative 33 comes from, and then we solve it a little bit like a linear equation from there, okay? And that whole process is called completing the square. So I'll leave that video there, and in my next video I'll look at the next example.